Welcome to the party. The four of us, along with Host Worldwide and you, are launching Windows 7 Ultimate Software. So, you know what? Let's take a minute or so to tell you about how great it is to host a launch party. You can use House Party tools to build your guest list, upload your pictures, which is his favorite, right? And you can even get a party pack. Though you're in your own home, you'll be able to participate with others in this exciting event around the world.
In a lot of ways, you're just throwing a party with Windows 7 as an honored guest. Sounds easy, and it is. But we thought you'd probably like to know what to do to get ready and how some hosts want their party to flow.
Mm-hmm. Right. Yeah. Well, now, the four of us got to have our parties a little ahead of schedule, mm-hmm. You know, try everything out. So we thought we'd be able to tell you some of the tips that help make our parties really fun.
Right. Yeah.
Now, of course, the first thing you want to do is install Windows 7.
Right?
Yeah, make sure you do that a couple days in advance of the party.
Call customer service if you have any questions.
Exactly.
You gotta play with Windows 7 before the party.
Second, look at the activities you and your guests can try at your party and choose the ones that seem to you to be the most fun.
There's a video of each activity from one of our parties, mm-hmm. and we have tried them all, mm-hmm. right?
Yep.
So you can see how the activity runs. And you know what? There's a handy page of notes to print out that tells you what you need ahead of time. I mean, it helps guide you along the party, right?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Print these out, because these are called host notes, and they're at the website.
Hey, again, you don't have to do the activities listed under your party theme.
Mm-hmm.
You just look at them all and decide which one seems to be the most fun for your guests.
Right.
And some of the host notes, they list bonus activities.
Oh, yeah.
Right.
But you may want to try them, but you have to make sure that you have the right devices on hand.
Mm-hmm. Right. Mm-hmm. And now, how the party flows is totally up to you.
Right.
Now, here's a sample agenda, though, that we each more or less followed.
Mm-hmm. Right. Now, for the first half hour or so at my party, the guests just came in, had a drink and a snack, and mingled like they do at any good party.
Right.
But many of the activities suggest that you have photos from the party, so we each made a point of shooting 20 or so photos on the digital camera at the start of the party, too.
Oh, my gosh. And, well, when everyone was there and settled, I led an overview of some of my favorite Windows 7 features. Mm-hmm. I showed my guests things from two of the Windows 7 orientation videos, and it took, like, 10 minutes.
Right.
Oh, you know it was great. It was totally informal. Like, everyone just kind of crowded around the computer in the kitchen.
Hey, we all started with some of the basic Windows 7 features, right?
Yeah. I mean, it's a good way to get things going, right? Mm-hmm. Whatever your party is, you got four separate videos of each of us doing bits and pieces of this kind of thing at our own parties.
Right.
Now, after my overview, I went straight to an activity.
Oh, you went straight to the activity.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, well, I let everybody fool around with Snap for a little while.
Me too. I did the same.
And then we started an activity maybe 30 minutes later.
Well, either way works, right? You figure out what your guests want and maybe just play it by ear. In any event, we each did an activity or two.
I did three activities.
Oh.
Yeah?
Oh, excuse me.
That's great. The activities each have you talk for a minute or so, and then you set something up so your guests can try. So for the rest of the party, you just leave your computer on and running, and then you let folks mess around with it, right? And the guests may have a question for you or something, or you may want to show them some things, but it was all really informal.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, and then when you're close to the end of the party.
Wanting everyone to leave?
Oh, boy. Towards the end, I showed the guests windows.com/help, and it's a great site for people to get more information, and I found it to be a nice wrap-up.
I agree. Help and how-to is a great way to bring it all together.
Yeah.
And it's a great resource for you hosts, too. You can find out pretty much anything you want to know about the features we're using for the activities.
Good point.
Yeah.
That is one way to flow the party, but again, it's all up to us, you. It's what's right for you and your guests.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
You know, the four of us learned quite a few things to help make our parties really a lot of fun.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Yeah. Here's mine. Make the thing you're demonstrating personal to someone at the party. Like the way I made chips files get transferred by Windows Easy Transfer.
Or the way I showed my guests web slices by talking about Frank's online auction shopping at his concert tee.
Or having folks edit photos of themselves to email home.
Yeah, right. I mean, bottom line, guests love it when the activity is about them.
Yeah. Hey, another thing, I found that it really helped to name the person to be the first with the hands-on activity and have them pick the next person, and so on and so on.
Oh, yeah,
yeah, I think you'll see that in a lot of our videos. Mm-hmm. It really helped get the guests onto the computer.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Okay, on a more serious note. Decide what activities you're going to do at least a day or two in advance. And
right.
Watch those videos and read the handouts.
Mm-hmm.
And some activities have modest setup. You know, they require certain things for you to have at the house.
Right.
Sure.
Mm-hmm.
Like you have to have two computers to do the web chatting activity.
Right. Right. And any case, none of the setup is too hard. right? You need to make sure that you're ready to go when your guests arrive, and there are bonus activities in some cases, and you want to go deeper, perhaps, into it, and you have to have the equipment to do that.
Right.
Hey, it helped me to remember that I'm not a salesman at this party.
Right.
I'm not supposed to be a total expert either.
Yeah.
This is a brand new product, and part of the fun of a launch party is seeing what you already know and what you can figure out. Mm-hmm. What is just so simple that anyone can do it.
Now, that is one of the great things about ending with help and how-to.
Right.
It's nice to be able to say throughout the party that you'll wrap it up with a great resource for any unanswered questions there.
Exactly.
Yeah, exactly.
I think the biggest thing is to be totally creative with the party and the activities.
Yeah.
I mean, this is your party.
Good.
Yeah,
good.
Exactly.
Right. Can you believe that Microsoft put the launch of Windows 7 in our hands?
Are
they nuts or what?
Huh? Maybe by letting you be involved.
Ooh. That was fun. I mean, I don't know. Really, it does make total sense. Windows 7 is all about the computer user, making everyday tasks more simple, working the way we all really want it to, and making new things possible. Mm. This really is our launch.
Yeah, you're right. So it ought to be a party.
Mm-hmm.
Have fun out there.
Cheers.
Have a good one, guys.
Oh my gosh, I'm so hungry. Let's eat.